Radio every week.
Radio on Lisa Brady. Tributes underway nationwide on this Veterans Day. President Obama at Arlington National Cemetery. Fox Radio's Rachel Sutherland live in Washington.
Lisa, this is President Obama's last Veterans Day as Commander-in-Chief. He laid a wreath at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier and then delivered an address inside the amphitheater, noting Veterans Day is often follows hard-fought political campaigns.
The American instinct has never been to find isolation in opposite corners. It is to find strength in our common creed, to forge unity from our great diversity.
President Obama said the nation's service members provide some of the best examples of coming together when it's hard. Lisa.
Meantime, one top Democrat on Capitol Hill blaming Donald Trump for violent protests over his election. Fox Radio's Jared Halpern live in D.C.
Despite calls from some leading Democrats to give President-elect Trump the chance to govern, outgoing Senate Democratic leader Harry Reid says Mr. Trump's election has emboldened the forces of hate and bigotry, writing the responsibility of healing belongs at the feet of Donald Trump, who Reid describes as a sexual predator who lost the popular vote. Senator Reid is retiring at the end of this term. He will not be in the Senate for the Trump administration. Other leading Democrats, like House Minority Leader Nancy Pelosi, have signaled a willingness to work with the president-elect on shared goals, like a transportation infrastructure bill. Lisa.
Thanks, Jared. The president-elect has called the demonstrations very unfair, but has also tweeted admiration for the protesters' passion. A train derailment prompting evacuations as a precaution near Ellendale, Minnesota. No injuries reported, but the Union Pacific train was carrying flammable liquid petroleum gas in at least one car, so they've cleared out a one-mile radius about 80 miles south of Minneapolis. Fair and balanced.
Shot at $1,000 now. Text the nationwide keyword GRAND to 200-200. You'll receive a confirmation text. Standard message and data rates apply. That's GRAND to 200-200.
1230 WBZT.
The thoughts and opinions expressed are those of the sponsors and don't necessarily reflect those of this station or iHeartMedia.
Well, it's noontime, and two boys from Brooklyn want to serve you a huge portion of humor for lunch. So, let's break out the lunch pail. Or the sandwich you packed. Les, Don, and Freddie S. bring you jokes and nostalgia mixed in with some important information about medicine, food, dating, or just the stuff you need to help that bagel go down nice and smooth. And if you have a story about anything you want to share, a bad date, a movie review, or just a strange thing that happened to you at work, call in and join the fun toll free at 1-800-889-0267 right now. So sit back and let's start the lunch break. Les, Don, and Freddie S. are ready to go. So here are the boys from Brooklyn and Don.
They're all right. All and they're right, in studio today.
You know, it's really funny. I think that she is in her own world. You know, I have a bit for you to open the show. We're going to talk about it afterwards.
Well, right.
It's all about the kids.
Good afternoon, South Florida, Atlanta, New York City, Chicago.
LA, San Francisco, and soon to be Houston. We have a big show in the house.
Huge.
But first, are we live streaming?
Yes.
You can find us live streaming this show, which is a very, very important show to be live streaming.
Are we live streaming? Yes, we're live streaming today.
Amp 2 TV Productions on Facebook. You can find us on Twitter, #2, #2, Boys from Brooklyn. And you can find us on Instagram, #2, Boys from Brooklyn.
How do you know all that?
It's connected between the pipes.
I bet you do.
It is Veterans Day, so
Happy Veterans Day
to everyone who is out there supporting our country currently and in the past. Thank you for all of your service that you do for us to be proud Americans.
That's right. Now, in the house today,
big show.
We have our DJs. We have our guest DJs. How's that?
Our guest DJs of the day. Right. Hey, guys.
How you doing, guys?
Sup, y'all?
Sup, y'all.
Wow. Sup, y'all.
There you have it. That's my kind of guy.
A natural.
You from the Bronx?
Sup, y'all. I love it.
What school? Give us some details, Nate. You want to?
We've got Jamali and Henry. You guys want to introduce yourselves?
Yeah.
Okay, give us some names of who you are.
My name is Henry, and I go to Wilton Reynolds Elementary, and I'm in the fifth grade.
Nice.
How about you, Mr. Jamali?
If y'all can't pronounce my name, y'all can call me JJ. That's Aww. What everybody calls me. And I go to Wilton Manors. I'm in fourth grade.
And you are looking very nice, you two young men.
I know.
If anyone who's listening to us on 1230 AM.
And what?
WBZT. 1230 AM. Please tune into our live stream and check out these handsome young men we have joining us for the day.
That's right. If you want to call in and be part of the show, 800-889-0267.
We've got some special guests. We've got our DJs of the day.
That's right. And you know, the funny thing about being a DJ at such an early age, fellas, is that you guys get to talk about anything you want to talk about today. Now, how, you get that at home, or you have to listen to everybody, what they talk about?
What do you think?
We basically do both.
Oh, there you go. So this should be easy. Simple.
What do you like to talk about?
If you had anything to talk about in the world right now, what would it be?
Video games.
Pokemon. Basketball.
Soccer.
You guys are Miami Heat fans?
No.
Do you like Pokemon?
God!
No!
Boy, I like these kids even more!
Do they ask them if they like Pokemon Go? Do you like Pokemon Go?
No.
No?
No, another one. These kids.
No Pokemon Go, no Heat. What do you like?
My favorite basketball team is the Cavaliers.
Nice.
Oh, because of Mr. LeBron James.
Really? No, because of Kyrie Irving.
Oh.
Oh, look at that. How impressive.
Yeah. They beat my Knicks up the first day, so you and I, we're going to talk later.
But how about you, Jamali?
I like soccer. I like the...
You like baseball?
Nope.
He likes soccer.
Swing and a miss.
So you guys were talking some politics on the way up?
Politics.
What were we talking about? The election?
They ain't into
like,
that.
Who won?
Donald Trump.
That's what Nikki
won the election.
Yeah, what do you think about that?
You okay with that?
I'm fine. It was a fair...
A fair fight?
Fair, yeah.
It was a fair fight.
Yeah.
See?
And the world didn't come to an end.
No. Everything's going to be all right.
Everything's good.
It's all about fairness.
Yeah. That's
being right. Kind to one another.
That's right.
What's your favorite food? You like guys like pizza? What do you like?
Well, they had breakfast before they got here. What'd you guys eat?
We ate egg. I mean, not eggs, but bacon and biscuit.
Delicious.
You didn't have no eggs?
You don't need eggs.
I don't need eggs.
When you got bacon, you don't need no
bacon
eggs.
Bacon and biscuits, but we have a very special thank you to Brooklyn Water Bagels because they have shared an amazing spread for our guests today.
Nice.
So there are 14 locations in South Florida. Go.
14?
14.
Yeah,
Brooklyn Water Bagels.
Water
at the Brooklyn Cafe. Yeah. So see the sign behind us?
It's the BB effect.
We are the Brooklyn Cafe. It is lunchtime. So the Brooklyn Water Bagels was kind enough to share some treats with all of us.
You guys excited to be here?
Yeah. Brooklyn Water Bagels.
That is a very good question. Brooklyn Water Bagels is a restaurant. They have bagels and muffins and eggs. Really great coffee when you get older. But we have plenty for Nate and Mark who are with us also.
And they bring the water. They fly the water down from Brooklyn, New York City.
They fly it or they pipe it in?
There's no such thing as a pipe from New York. Go on, take it easy.
You think they put all the water on a plane? They have a special filtration system.
They do. They have a filtration system.
They put the water on a plane, and then the plane is like gushy.
They fill up the whole plane with water.
Because you know what they say? Bagels from New York are supposed to be the better tasting bagel because
of the water.
It's all in the water.
So we're going to have to... Have you guys test some of the bagels?
So what does water have to do with bagels in this?
Do you ever bake? Have you ever baked a cake or
you
cookies
like
or brownies?
Yeah, gingerbread cookies.
There you go.
So think of some of the ingredients you put in when you bake.
Eggs, flour.
Water.
Water.
Yeah,
water. Water, and there you go.
So the water, if the water is like from Florida, it comes out flat.
If it's from
New York, it comes out big.
Imagine if you put in sparkling water.
That's just a theory. That's just a theory.
It's a theory?
That people say, oh, the water's better in New York.
It is.
It's just a preference.
It's the best water in the world.
I believe that.
With all its contaminants.
But they're excited to be here. What do you guys want to be when you grow up?
Ooh. A basketball player.
Nice.
Ooh. For the Cavaliers?
Yep.
What about JJ?
U.S. Military Air Force.
Holy smokes.
Wow.
Thank you. Pick up this kid.
What? He's an old soul.
What do you think, JJ? What makes you want to do that?
I like planes.
Oh, my gosh.
Hey, do you
God
know
bless
something?
You.
The way you dress, my man, you look full military gear. We should have dressed them up like a soldier or something.
They're looking pretty nice, these boys, aren't they?
Impressive. He's wearing a tie and everything else. I feel naked here.
And we also have Nate Osgood with us.
Hello.
Hello, Nate.
And we have Mark. I'm sorry, I don't know your last name.
Mark Doggy from Kids in Distress.
How you guys doing? Mark, I want to thank you for helping us out with this. It's we've been working with Nate for a while now to try to get this accomplished.
Thank you for having us. Nate is actually one of our board members at Kids in Distress and helps us out with a lot of things, a lot of our events, and getting our kids involved in many activities in the community, and especially mentoring our kids, which is incredibly important.
Well, that's what it's all about. Do you want to talk a little bit about
your program?
About your program and some of the stuff you guys have cooking?
Sure. Kids in Distress is one of the largest child and family agencies in South Florida. We work with over 11,000 kids through Broward and Palm Beach counties through a lot of different services, different activities and programs. We have actually the largest foster care program in Broward and Palm Beach County. On our campus, we have a preschool early childhood education center. An aftercare program with about 85 kids in it. And then we have a huge contingency of social workers, therapists, family support workers who actually work with families who are either, you know, at risk of some things happening in their homes, just to support them to keep families together. So that's in both Broward and Palm Beach counties.
Excellent. And then some of the foster stuff that I've been watching, I think it's Channel 12. You know, they have this campaign where they want to help older kids get families and things of that nature. So they do an interview, and then they come back to it a couple of months later. Have you seen this stuff?
I have, yeah.
Holy smokes, man. You talk about not a tear in the...
Not a dry eye in the room.
It was unbelievable.
Yeah.
There's a really significant need for foster families, both in Broward and Palm Beach counties. So we're one of the licensing entities, and we're constantly recruiting families who want to take a child into their home and mentor that child and keep that child safe and have that child be a part of their family.
Is it difficult? Because a lot of people are afraid of how difficult it is to...
It's really not as difficult as you might think. You know, really you have to have a heart, big heart, open your home up. The licensing process is really only 7 weeks of classes, and then you certainly have to have somebody come into your home to be sure that it's safe and warm. But the process is probably not as difficult as people really think that it is.
Excellent.
I think people probably feel overwhelmed and they think, how can I do this? Well, these children want to live with me. But the amount of love that we can all give to and outreach to kids that need more love, and everyone needs more love, right, guys?
Yes.
You know, it's really funny. Didn't you introduce me to somebody who had an adopted daughter on your other show?
Yes. And she was in JAFCO.
Yep.
And a teenager. She got adopted at 6 weeks before her 18th birthday. And she was a special, a forever friend of my sister
right. And
her wife. And then she went to her special needs teacher and said, I really want to be adopted. And she's in high school, and she's hearing impaired, and she's graduating this year from South Plantation High School, and she's going to college. Yeah. And she was adopted 6 weeks before she turned 18. Yeah. She just said, please.
I remember. She Dawn has another show that she does down in Boca, and they put her on the air. I was like, wow.
And they called in. And the biggest thing that I learned from that is if you don't ask, if kids don't say help, and in any way that kids can say help, however they express their need for love, this girl said please in her words and in sign language. But there's so many ways if you just open your eyes and open your heart and say, yes, I can do this. I've got more space in my heart, because I know we all do, especially this time of year.
Yeah.
Right, we're getting ready for Thanksgiving, guys, and
yes.
Christmas.
Be sure to gather all those canned goods for poor people. We ain't want them, sorry.
I'm going to tell you something. This kid is unreal.
Where are we doing a food drive, Mr. JJ?
For my school, we're doing it at Wilton Manors, and we're putting it someplace. I don't know.
So what are you collecting for kids?
Canned goods and other type of stuff for people who need it, and we also did that for breast cancer.
Nice.
And last year, we bought socks and donated it to the school for breast cancer.
How does it make you feel to help other people?
Great, because you can tell all of the people that you know what you did for others.
What do you think, JJ?
I like it. It's good.
Did you bring canned goods in from home?
Yes.
Not yet.
I know, we're getting some feedback. That's because we have so many people listening.
That's what
so many people on air.
That's what it comes down to. And what do you guys, let me ask you a question. You like school, yes?
Yes.
Good
not
answer.
Not really.
JJ is, here.
I just don't like waking up in the morning.
It's still dark when you get up, don't it? Isn't it?
Or is it depends on what time I wake up, but I normally wake up at 7:30.
On the weekend, I wake up until 10.
Nice. Remember those days when you were a kid and you could actually sleep until 10?
Yeah, about 30 years ago.
Yeah, what happened to that? Enjoy it now, guys.
Because then you're going to have a job.
Yeah, exactly.
That's right.
But this is one of the best jobs, and I think Mark and Nate have some amazing jobs as well. I mean, look, they get to work with you guys and all of your friends all the time.
I also have an amazing job.
You do? What do you do?
Go to school every morning and do my work.
You're right.
You know, that's right. You know, I used to tell my sons that. He used to go, you going to work? I said, so are you. You guys look like you're ready for business. Now, let me ask you a different question. You like going to school. You like playing basketball, right? Do your friends know that you're on the air today?
My brothers and sisters.
You didn't tell your friends? You're going to be the envy of the block.
Oh, no. We ain't have time to tell our friends. So.
Really? Look at JJ. What's
JJ,
up?
JJ, he's bouncing out of his seat.
I got a good one. There's Henry's brother, Nicole. He thought that we weren't going to be here today, and look at us now.
Wow. You should say hi to everybody on air.
Hello, everyone. Tell them to go to Amp2 TV Productions on Facebook, and they can see you live. They can see you. What was his name that told that he didn't believe we were going to be on the air?
Your brother? How many brothers and sisters do you have, Henry?
It's 7 boys and 3 girls.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh,
what a big
small family. You got a baseball team.
How about you, JJ?
He's counting.
He's counting your brothers. How many brothers and sisters do you have?
I got 3 brothers and 2 sisters.
Wow.
I think JJ just realized that. I got 3 brothers.
He's like,
you were counting. You know you have 5 siblings, right? 3 and 2?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Including me, it's 3.
Oh, including you, it's 3. Okay.
Brothers and 2 sisters.
Yeah.
There you go.
How's that muffin going down?
Good.
Shout out to Brooklyn Water Bagel. Do they not make one of the better chocolate chip muffins you've ever had?
Mm-mm.
No.
My mom makes better.
Your mom does.
Oh, well. It's nothing like home cooking.
And my grandma.
Yeah, my family wouldn't know about that.
Why? Because you don't cook?
Because I don't cook.
Yeah, you don't have to let out all your deep secrets. You didn't have to tell nobody you don't cook. Just tell them I do cook.
You know
I buy and serve.
Here's the thing.
I do cook.
If I can bring all of this greatness home and then spend a lot of my time with kids like this, why cook?
That's a way to spend it, honey.
You know what? It's all about my priorities.
That's right.
Having you guys on the air today, we've worked with Nate for a long time trying to find a special day to bring you guys up. Had to wait for a day off of school.
That's right. Even though I told him that I would give you a grade, this could be a classroom. Mics and TVs and camera. You ever been in a place like this before?
Nope.
Well, there you have it.
What did you think when you came into iHeart Studios?
Well, I really thought it would be much more different.
What did you think?
I thought it would be like a studio. It would be dark and lights flashing everywhere.
I could
like
take the windows
bus.
Out.
That's TV.
I could take
TV.
The windows out. Yeah, that is TV.
That's TV.
But unfortunately, we have to do radio and TV. We can make it real dark in here, but then, you know, they won't like it too much.
Yeah, because they won't be able to see it.
But we don't own the studio. It's given to, you know, other people use the studio all day long, so they like the lights. So
Henry, do you get to go to the center where Mark is after school? Or you go on weekends? Do they go to a location?
Both boys live on our campus in Wilton.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's what she meant. Yes.
Okay.
Don't confuse everybody, don't.
I was a little confused.
You are very confused.
So we're neighbors.
Nice. How many kids live where you are?
And where I am?
And you're on campus.
That's a nice question.
Oh, he liked that one.
Oh, good. It only took me 20 minutes to ask a good question.
About 20,
28?
About 28.
Wow. Nice. Good answer.
Excellent. Smart man.
How long have you all both lived there?
I lived there for 3 years already.
And how about you, JJ?
For this one,
Three months.
And what do you like most about it?
How we get to play.
Yeah, and as soon as we wake up in the morning, if the staff is out and they're ready, and the kids are dressed, we can go outside and play. But my favorite is the basketball court.
From the mouths of babes, they get up and get to play. That should be a lesson for all of us.
I know. Right? We do the same thing, right? Everybody accuses of getting up, going to work.
And having fun. Yeah. But isn't it all about having fun, guys?
No.
Nah.
It's called work before play.
There you go.
Good work ethic. What are you doing to these guys, Nate?
Well, it's not me. I'm going to put my finger at Mark first,
like a Nate
but I like it. Work before play.
That's right.
What does that mean?
I disagree.
You do your work first. And
of course you do, JJ.
After you finish all your work, that's when you play.
You do your work commitments and then play. How about you, JJ?
Disagree.
But JJ wants
what
to play
What do you like
first.
To do?
He's on Hollywood Squares right now.
Yeah.
He disagrees.
What do you like to do on campus?
On campus, I like to play with the bikes and stuff and how we get to go out sometimes.
Where do you get to go to?
To the movies. To go out to eat dinner or lunch.
Nice.
Sometimes.
Well, he likes the finer things in life.
He likes to have some fun.
So those are the finer things in life. You like to go out, movies and dinners and stuff. So in order to be doing those things, you got to do the work. You got to have the jobs. You got to do the work, earn the keep, and there you go. You like to go to what kind of movies? You know, it's funny he says that, right? What kind of movies you like to go to?
You mean the name of it?
Yeah, I mean, what kind of movies? You like comedies? You like thrillers? You like scary movies?
You like Star Wars? What do you like?
Stunts movies? Stunt movies?
Stunt movies.
Action.
Action-packed.
Jamali, what kind of work do you guys do?
Work?
Yeah. You know that other word.
Yeah, that was Henry's work. What kind of Henry does his schoolwork. You do any work before you play?
Yeah, sometimes.
Like what?
Geometry.
Oof. In the fourth grade.
Mm-hmm. Wow, raising the bar high. I'm glad I'm not a kid.
It's not hard.
Are you good at math?
Mm-hmm.
I stink.
You're good at math? What's your favorite subject?
Recess.
Why am I so not surprised
by
that
answer? Do you have an agent?
Maybe you should come co-host with us every day.
I think you need an agent. You have a good sense of humor.
He's got comedic timing.
You got it.
He's got the it.
He's got the it factor. Henry, what's your favorite subject?
I'm going to go with Spanish.
Really?
¿Y tú hablas español?
I don't know what you mean. I'm now learning.
But he likes it.
Because I'm Latino, so I can speak to you in Spanish.
My mom is. She's Spanish.
She's Spanish?
Mm-hmm.
Do you speak Spanish?
A little bit.
¿Tú me entiendes?
I said a little bit.
It was two words, JJ.
Hola might be a good start.
Hola, ¿cómo estamos? Hola. Hola?
Hola means hello. I know that.
Muy bien, gracias.
Muy bien, gracias. There you go. Very well, thank you.
Means thank you. Gracias means you're welcome, right? Or is it the other way around?
Which one?
I think it's the other way around.
What's the words?
Muy bien and gracias. Gracias is thank you. And
gracias. Muy bien is very well, thank you.
Now, I'm looking at Nate, I'm looking at Mark, and their faces are just so lit up watching you guys. I think you warm their heart.
Very cool.
And also at Kids in Distress, if you have any children, we have camp for the summer. We have a summer camp and preschool for the little kids.
He's like an ambassador.
He's like a salesman.
Yeah.
Nice.
So I'm sold.
True. Are you the voice for Kids in Distress?
What?
You're the voice. You're the face. The two of you.
We're going to make a poster of you like you see in this room.
Talking about posters, I was about to ask.
Okay.
Is a hot dog the mascot of you guys?
Yes, it is.
Because right now, there's a lot of hot dogs around.
That's
here.
Right. In New York City, that's what they do, a lot of hot dogs.
I'm getting pretty scared.
Why?
You're a smart boy.
They're everywhere.
They're everywhere.
Oh, you have a question. What's your question?
How do you eat hot dogs?
With your hands.
He's a natural.
Do you eat it with ketchup or mustard?
Oh, me, I eat hot dog, my hot dog with ketchup.
There you go. You're in the club. And you like what? Right.
I like mustard.
You like mustard. 50, 50. Why didn't they think that? Well, of course.
Why would you think they'd have the same answer?
Of course not. I think this guy invented mustard.
I think he might have. He's having a great time over there.
In New York City, the show is based out of a place called Brooklyn, which is part of New York City. Nathan the Hot Dogs, when we were growing up, was a big deal. So we sort of have hot dogs as a logo type of thing.
Like you a see, mascot, like you said.
You see my little hot dogs here?
Yeah, so what is your logo?
A hot dog.
What is a logo?
I mean, what are you guys' logo? What's your logo?
Well, you got y'all Brooklyn. Have. See the Brooklyn Cafe? Mm-hmm. On this side of Brooklyn, where that picture is taken from the bridge, on this side of Brooklyn, there is a cafe there. This is a true story. It's called the Brooklyn Cafe. Did you know that?
I did not.
Yeah, they film movies and everything there. It only holds 6 people. It's the smallest thing I've ever seen in my life.
But
it's like
movie
a dollhouse.
Set?
No, it's a real cafe, but it's an icon. And they wanted to tear it down when I was a kid, and they didn't do this. So.
Nice.
That's where I got the idea of doing
the Brooklyn Cafe.
But
Brooklyn
this kid's cafe. Got the right idea. He's already thinking of imaging.
This kid
already,
is an agent. What
right?
are you talking about?
And logos.
He's got logos on the mind.
He got everything. He's
Look,
taking
he's
everything
observing
in.
Observing everything. I like it.
Trademark everything. Lock right? him up.
That's it. He's asking you about your imaging. What's your logo? See?
I know,
he's like an agent already.
He's an agent.
I have another question.
Of course you do. Bring it out.
Who came up with the name I Heart?
You know, that's a long
Bob
story.
Pittman.
Yeah. Pittman came up with I Heart because he wanted to say that he wanted to control all the media from his heart. It's a true story.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know who knows Pittman?
No.
You
do.
Don't believe it.
You do.
Not me. I wish. Les.
Les, of course he does.
Les.
He came from MTV, you know.
Did he?
Uh-huh.
What, begging for forgiveness?
I'm gonna JJ, kidding. You have a question? All right, what's your question?
Who is Pittman?
He's the owner. Okay. He owns all this stuff.
He's the CEO. He's not the owner.
The CEO of iHeart.
The owner of the stockholders.
What does
that stand for? He's kind of the boss. He runs the place.
He's like a Mark.
Kind of like Mark does
he's
on
like
your
Mark.
Campus. Does Mark run the place?
Who runs
Henry,
the place?
Henry, who runs where you guys live?
Where we live?
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Who's
Mostly
the boss?
The people, basically, Mr. Mark.
Mr. Mark. And that's kind of like Mr. Pittman.
Mr. Mark. He's like a Pittman.
Can you give us some info on what's going on? I see you've got some amazing activities
coming up.
We've actually got some really fun events coming up, both in December and January. One of the real exciting events on our campus in Wilton Manors is our Family Fitness Challenge, which is on December 3rd. And what we're going to do is we're actually combining a cycling event with a spinning event with a big, huge holiday party where all of our kids from our foster homes and from the community come in and celebrate the holidays and also celebrate the folks who are raising money for us. So that's on December 3rd. And we need spinners and cyclists. So if you're a spinner or cyclist, come on by and get a workout. And if you just want to stop by because you're interested in our agency or becoming a foster parent, that's it's a fun event. And then in January, our Kid Auxiliary, who has raised like over $6 million for our organization, they're having our Kid Hero 5K out at Vista View Park in Davie, Florida. And that's on January 28th. And another fun event, especially for the families, because we encourage people to dress up as superheroes. So many of our kids, both Hillary and JJ, will come out, and they're going to hopefully wear a Superman costume and do our 5K with us.
Oh, yeah.
And the superhero of their choice.
Hey, Mark, what kind of superhero are you going to be?
I prefer Superman.
There you go.
Who would you guys want to be? What superhero would you come dressed as?
War Machine.
Okay, how about you, Henry?
A ninja.
A ninja. Mm. Nate, what are you dressing up as?
Ninjas aren't super.
Whoa.
They keep the world safe.
Nice. I would probably dress as Batman. That's kind of my favorite.
I thought you were going to come as a sheriff or something.
The Dark Knight.
Oh, there you go.
So there's a whole kids' fitness challenge on December 3rd?
December 3rd, the fitness challenge is on our campus. Starts. The cycling event starts at 6 o'clock, and the spinning event will have like 30 spin bikes. And you can actually go to our website, www.kidinc.org, and find out more and how to register. And you can register online, and you know, for a very small registration fee, you can come out and have a ball and get a workout at the same time and meet our kids.
Very cool. Listen, I was asked to ask, do you guys have any special people in your life? A girlfriend? Anything like that?
Well, we could talk about it on the set, but that's
well, we could.
That's too much.
Not on live. Not on live.
We don't have to tell her name.
No, I don't. We don't have to talk about her.
It's a yes, but you or guys no
have
answer.
A, yeah, yes, I have a girlfriend. No, I don't.
Maybe so.
Ooh. Maybe so.
JJ, he's grinning from ear to ear.
Yeah.
Yes, you
how
do.
How many girlfriends you got, JJ?
Three. The laughter says it all. There's no denying it. He's got a few.
Look at him. He's turning color.
Look at him.
He's all embarrassed.
I know. He's blushing.
We
won't tell. They don't have to know.
I'm telling. They're how many girlfriends listening. You got?
He's got three. I'm telling you.
You got three girlfriends?
JJ's got three?
One more. One less.
Then one two. More. Two
one
or four?
More.
One
two.
Less.
Two.
One. Right?
One less.
That we know
zero?
Of.
Zero?
Three. One less.
Two. Two. You have two girlfriends?
Yeah.
It's all over his face that he has more though. Than one.
How about you, Henry?
One.
Just one.
I'm not that type of guy.
He's the comedian type of guy.
Yes.
Good answer.
You got a player?
Nice. No. All right. Good for you, man.
Well, that's because you're a little older.
I like Hank. I like him.
JJ has to, you know, he's got to get to yellow. He's got to find out what he wants.
Well, JJ, you know, he's going to be a pilot, so of course he's going to have more than
he's
gonna one.
He's going to be in the military brass boy, they're right? In uniform. They're going to be all after him.
No kidding. He knows.
Women
he knows
love
what's
guys
up.
In uniform.
He's been is on this true? Planet before.
He's been what?
You know, like officer and a gentleman.
He's been on this planet before.
His
old right, soul. JJ is an old soul. Have
it?
You ever been on a plane?
Yeah.
What do you like most about flying on planes?
The window.
I really don't know. But I mostly like looking at the sky and stuff.
Yeah, I like that too.
How you get to look up high, see everything.
Get
down
to
low.
See everything. Did you guys see the sunset last night?
No.
No.
It was beautiful.
Do you guys have any hobbies? Like, do you draw or artist or paint or anything like that?
None. Pranking.
Pranking? Really? Nice. How interesting.
Yeah, that is interesting.
Such
you know,
as
pranking
what?
Pranking is a hobby.
It is.
I don't know. Maybe when you were a kid, we've heard some stories from you.
Yeah, I was.
Some have made a career out of pranking.
That's
let me
right.
tell you.
Some people make a living at it.
Some people make a lot of money out of pranking.
What kind of pranks do you do?
There's this one that I thought was really funny the first time I did it. So I tried doing it again, but it wasn't that funny the second time. But the first time, it was hilarious. We did fake vomit, right?
And oh, that's
we
hilarious.
We sprayed this stinky spray on it, right? And since we would do pranks a lot then, my auntie, right, she would think that, she would know that we would be doing it, right? So she would know. So we wanted to do something that she thought it would be real this time.
Mm.
So we did. She knew it was fake. But when she smelled it, she ran off crying, screaming, everything. It was hilarious.
Wow.
Did you crack up laughing or did you not laugh?
I laughed hard. Me and Mordecai, my friend.
Yeah, who put that together, you or Mordecai?
Both.
Nice.
Who came up with the spray?
Mordecai. Hmm.
Yeah, Mordecai.
See? Mordecai. Anybody
wait,
named Mordecai?
Anybody with that kind
it's
of name.
It's the name. It's Mordecai.
Name.
You better, Mark, you better keep an eye on these guys.
I
and
love
they,
it.
And they talk about Trump? Hello.
Right. So shall we do a break?
Future leaders, man.
Future.
Sure. We're going to take a quick break.
Take
give
a quick
us a
break.
Call. Talk to the guys. 800-889-0267. We'll be right back.
We shall be turned.
Please welcome a new sponsor to the show. It's AMP2 TV, the first and only internet network that's truly plugged in. When you're looking for a full-service internet television production company, discover AMP2 TV, a full-service production company that can provide all streaming videos in-studio or remotely. They offer web page development, and they use all the latest platforms to help make your business selling points more powerful. They can do remotes and live streaming, as well as tape productions. Let AMP2 TV handle all of your television production needs. Choose from a variety of creative TV and radio packages and see why AMP2 TV works with many major companies, including Comcast, Bravo, and Fox 29, as well as individuals and businesses of all types and sizes. To see samples of their work or to find out more, visit their website at amp2.tv. That's A-M-P, the number 2, dot TV. Or call them at 1-866-224-5422. That's 866-224-5422.
Have you ever had a business idea that you thought would be a great solution to tough challenges in today's world, but have no idea how to get started? You don't want to waste investment money on ideas that just don't work. Introducing Health and Wealth Seminars, a sophisticated advertising agency with over 40 years in the ad business. What makes Health and Wealth different from other agencies is they fit your product into the public's need. They help put together the strategy of your business before you commit thousands of dollars and just find out those ideas just don't work. Health and Wealth Seminars carry advertising contracts, radio and television contracts, and even a production service contract that will cover all of your business needs. Call today, 954-303-9563, and let Health and Wealth Seminars carry your business to the next level. The number is 954-303-9563. And remember that what happens when you don't advertise is nothing. 954-303-9563 is the number you need to get your business started in the right direction.
Hi, it's Leah, here to tell you about Dr. Anthony Pinozzo. He's a pain specialist located in Southern Palm Beach County, so if you are somebody that you know is suffering in pain, Dr. Pinozzo is the one you guys need to call. And make that call today, because living in pain is no way to go through life. Dr. Pinozzo has been in practice now for more than 49 years. He's treated more than 73,000 patients for pain. He's an expert when it comes to diagnosing the pain, and he has had huge turnarounds. In fact, people with living with scoliosis, he has had nearly a 100% turnaround. Lumbar pain as well. If you've got lower back pain, if you're suffering with migraines or flat feet pain, maybe pain in your elbows, your neck, your shoulders, Dr. Pinozzo can help you. And the greatest thing is he can help you without drugs, without surgery, and without having to go through weeks and months of rehabilitation. Give him a call today. Set up an appointment. It's 561-381-5800. Tune into his show Sundays, 11 to noon.
Know your body. Gain control of your health. Transform your life. If your body could talk, what would it tell you? At DexaFit, they show you how to take control of your health and fitness to live a happier, more fulfilling life. Since 2011, DexaFit has measured thousands of clients' body composition and fitness performance levels across the country. Hormones, metabolic health, and cardio fitness all play a significant role in your energy levels, your sleep quality, and overall well-being. With their proven methods of measure, track, and discover, they show you how your body composition, cardio fitness, and metabolic health compare to your optimal level. They make sure you're continuing to make progress and follow the best nutrition and fitness plans for your body type. At DexaFit, the goal is to help you identify and understand the health and fitness of how to transform your body to meet your individual goals, break through your plateaus, and take the guesswork out. Improve your energy level, sleep, and weight. Discover what's holding you back. Call 561-923-8833. DexaFit is conveniently located at 2499 Glades Road in Boca Raton. For more information, contact them at boca@dexafit.com or schedule an appointment online at dexafit.com. Identify your health risks and optimize longevity and fitness. Call 561-923-8833 and mention this ad for special pricing.
Is your child's tablet time greater than engaged activity time? Are you seeking better wellness strategies for your family? Do you want to redefine what your family's quality time looks like? At New Dawn Health Solutions, we focus on the four pillars of health coaching: lifestyle, exercise, attitude, and nutrition, to create a balanced approach to wellness. Together, we will open the conversation with you and your children on ways to empower healthy eating, increase physical activity, and set goals. Let's talk about the issues that are important to your family's health. Give New Dawn Health Solutions a call at 561-901-2854 or email us at dawn@newdawnhealthsolutions.com.
You're lunching with two boys from Brooklyn who invite you to advertise on the show. Share your good news. Just call 866-224-5422 and get all the information. There are plenty of options, and this could be a great chance to get the word out about your business or service. That's 866-224-5422. Now let's get back to those two boys from Brooklyn.
And we're back.
Two boys from Brooklyn and Dawn. Yeah, we got to get that fixed.
Two boys from Brooklyn and Dawn with guest DJs, JJ and Henry.
Yes, but before we get to that, let's thank our sponsor.
Thank our sponsor, Dr. Anthony Pinozzo. Needles Pinozzo gets rid of your pain in a snap.
In a snap.
Give him a call at
561-381-5800.
And I believe he has a show today? Sunday. Channel 19?
Yeah, he's, what's today?
Friday.
Yeah, he's
it's
on
Funky
Channel
Friday.
19, 6, 6.30.
And Sunday's at 11 to 12.
12.30 a.m. WBZT and 94.3 FM, our sister station.
Dr. P's been on vacation, but he will be back next week, and we'll have him on the phone to join us.
I'm beginning to hear he's going to be back this week.
So well, this week, Monday next week. Yeah, it's all a matter of semantics, what in the week is.
Also, we want to thank Brooklyn Water Bagels for their wonderful breakfast.
Beautiful spread they provided for everybody. 14 locations in South Florida. Josh Westaway. He's regional manager of six of them. He will be here on Wednesday. Put some more food.
Nice.
I got nothing right yet.
You're close, though.
And also, we want to thank DexaFit, our sponsor.
Thank DexaFit.
Go and get healthy.
After you go to Brooklyn Water Bagels, then you go to DexaFit.
Swallow a bagel and then go get DexaFit.
Their bagels, their muffins, everything is really delicious. I think these guys are enjoying it.
That's true. Yeah.
Yes?
Mm-hmm. It's really good.
So while we are on break, Jamali, our new producer, our segment producer, has quite a few questions, and he's come up with a lot of things he wants to ask.
That's right.
So you ready?
Yeah.
All right.
What do you want to ask?
What do you want to ask? You can move the mic closer to you.
Yeah, don't go so far away. Go ahead.
Whoa. Ow.
What do you want to ask?
What do you want to ask? You've got some questions.
Don't be shy.
Well, I wanted to ask, pretty much now, I want to just pretty ask, why am I so funny?
Why are you so funny? Henry seemed to think you're hysterical. I think it's the way you deliver your comedy.
Do you know they pay people a lot of money to be funny?
That's right.
A lot. When I tell you a lot of money, it'll buy a lot of hot dogs, I'm going to tell you.
Why are we talking about hot dogs right now?
That's just a, you know, an example.
Okay. I wanted to ask another question.
Yeah.
But it wasn't on break.
It was, what are your favorite shoes and stuff?
Why do we call hot dogs hot dogs?
That's a very complicated question.
That's because of a cartoon.
Y'all should really know about it. Since
I know it.
Now we know it. But
Carol knows the answer. That's Carol in there.
Hi. It's because of a little cartoon strip that was in the newspaper in New York a long time ago. They were comparing it to the hot dog dogs, so it stuck.
The Dachshunds.
The Dachshunds.
Dachshund.
The wiener dogs.
The wiener dogs. Yep.
That's it. So
the wiener dogs.
There you have it in a nutshell.
That's it.
I have a question for you guys. On your campus, what do you have there? What do you have? Basketball?
Yeah.
We have
got
a playground.
You got a what?
A playground.
Playground.
With the slides and stuff.
And bikes.
And we also have the bike area. Like when we start to clean up, we put the bikes in the bike rack. And the balls, we have a little, kind of like the pussy buggy, but it has two handles.
Okay.
And we put the balls in there. It's a blue bin.
You keep the balls where you clean up. Mark and Nate, can you tell us about the campus?
Sure.
Other kids in distress, what you have, what you offer?
Absolutely. We've got a 5-acre campus just north of downtown Fort Lauderdale. And we have 4 foster homes on campus. The boys said there was 28 kids that live in those foster homes. But we also have a dental clinic on our campus in collaboration with Nova Southeastern University. We have a early childhood education center with about 120 kids that come to on campus every single day. At an aftercare program, about 85 kids that come to our aftercare program from our local schools. And
optometry.
That's right. We have an eye optometry clinic. Again, Nova Southeastern University operates an optometry clinic on our campus. Thank you, Henry. And then, you know, a couple of offices as well that, you know, that hold our family counseling center, our therapists, our maternal health programs that work with new moms out in the community, and then another office that works with folks who need housing, folks who need a house, and it's a supportive housing program.
That's a lot of stuff.
You have seven kids in a home?
There's 7 kids in each home, and there's 2 great big playgrounds, and then we don't have a pool, but we have a water play area, a great big whale that streams water, so the kids get to play in that, and a great big playground that has a huge basketball court, so the kids love to play basketball.
And how do you identify the kids and their families?
The kids that are on campus really are children who have a large sibling group. So, you know, one of the things that we don't want to happen is when the kids go to live in a, with a family, is to go to a home that they're going to be separated. So what we do is we have four homes on campus, and we have kids that come on campus that might be members of a large sibling group. And so we keep those kids together as a sibling group on our campus. We have foster parents that live there 24/7 and take care of the kids.
Wow. So you've got parents living in your house?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Very cool.
So there's seven kids, and you have how many parents live with you guys?
One. In my house, one.
How about you, JJ?
Just one. And the other two houses, because there's four, the other two is two parents.
And girls and boys live in the same house?
No.
Well, they don't.
The siblings do.
Siblings
do. Okay. So you all stay together.
Mm-hmm.
How does it make you feel?
Good.
It's good because we're not separated or on another side.
You all get to stay together in the same house.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. There's this thing that I always used to say when I was little, like six or five. Always stay from the other side.
What does that mean?
Because there's this closet in my room, right?
Uh-huh.
It's always dark in there. There's no light switch in there, right? And
sure, we could fix that.
Since, you know, most little kids fear of monsters, right? I always say, stay away from the other side, because my bed was on this side and the closet was on that side.
It's kind of like Star Wars, stay away from the dark side.
Mm-hmm. Something like that.
JJ, what about if I get you a lamp?
A lamp.
Put a lamp over in that corner.
I don't need it anymore. I'm gone. I'm gone with that house.
Oh, there you go.
You have a light now in your house where you are?
Mm-hmm.
You have a light in the closet?
Well, actually, we don't have a closet.
Oh, okay.
We have a closet, but not in our rooms. Not in my room.
Excellent. I'm going to tell you, this kid's going to take your job, Mark.
Mm-hmm.
Unbelievable. All right. So let me ask you about the future. Expansion. What are you looking to do with the organization?
Our largest need right now is mostly to recruit foster homes in the community. So we're constantly recruiting families to take children into their homes.
Right.
You know, there's such a significant need in both Broward and Palm Beach counties to license additional homes, recruit additional homes. And one of the differences in our organization is that we support those homes through a period of time. We have a very small ratio with social workers to homes, so we're on call 24/7 to support those homes if they have a child in them. And one of the really neat statistics is that about 80% of the kids that come to us for placement are under the age of 5. So we have a lot of young kids.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of young kids that we need families to, you know, take them into their homes and into their families.
How long can these kids stay with you on campus?
It really varies. You know, the kids will stay with us until either, you know, there's a permanent option for them, you know, until they're either reunified with their families or, you know, there's a more permanent option. You know, one of the things that we pride ourselves in is that when kids come to us is they stay with us until they find a forever home.
Gotcha. How long has your organization been around?
We've been around for 37 years.
Oh, you just started.
Agency started, yeah.
Kind of new,
but not really. We started in 1980 as a very small shelter when we were only providing services to about 24 kids at that time, and now we impact about 11,000 children throughout Broward and Palm Beach counties.
Unbelievable. Do you have other places that work with you on this different umbrella or other centers or other places?
We're really good at early childhood education and services involving children and families, but we do collaborate with many other organizations in the community. You know, we collaborate with the Urban League of Broward County, with Legal Aid Services, with Women in Distress, you know, many other organizations that have a specialty that, you know, maybe it's a service that we don't offer.
Gotcha.
And Nate's done a lot to help you.
Well, I can
which
tell
is
you,
how we met in the first place, right?
Yeah, that's correct. What Mark didn't mention, which I'm going to go over some of the things.
Yes,
right,
let's
here.
Do that.
Kid Fitness Challenge is coming up December 3rd, and we're going to invite everyone to come out to participate in the bicycle ride, the challenge bicycle ride, and that's a three hour spinning challenge class, coming with the holiday fun. So, please do come out for this event.
And where is this?
We're going to get started right at Kids in Distress Shelter, correct, Mark? Mm-hmm. 819 Northeast 26th Street in Wilton Manors.
Yep. Okay.
And that's December 3rd.
December 3rd. And I'll give you a website to go on it.
Excellent.
That's KID Fitness Challenge. KID FITNESSCHALLENGE.org.
Beautiful.
And your fraternity, I know, your organization, you had a white party.
That's correct. That's the Alpha Phi Alpha White Party for Kids in Distress. We put that on once a year. I think we've done it six times, sixth annual. So We raise just about $11,000 for kids in distress, and we do it with the party with the purpose. The way we go out, we invite you to come out, and we just have a party. We bring awareness. We talk about, one, we need foster parents. One, we need your funding. We need your money to help go back to the programs. Yesterday, it goes towards, like, my, I think Jamali just mentioned to me he had to go to the dentist. And he had two teeth removed, right?
Hey, guys.
Let me see your teeth, Jamali.
You had two teeth removed yesterday, and you're here?
When were they extracted? When?
At the top?
Yeah.
Two at the top?
So, wow. So the funding we do, it goes a long way, but we can always use more funding. And we need more foster parents, and we definitely need mentors to help groom our young men and women to be productive citizen in life.
So people can volunteer on so many levels. They can donate, of course.
Yes.
They can mentor and come in and volunteer. You have a program, I'm assuming, to train them?
Yes, and Mark can talk about that also. We have a volunteer program, and we have lots of volunteers that come on the campus to help out in all different areas. As a matter of fact, Mark's wife is one of our biggest volunteers.
Of course.
And she does a lot of work there, you know, and just kudos to all the volunteers that come out to give so much of their time to help out our young people.
And you're really looking for foster parents.
That's correct.
Well, I'm going to tell you, you sent this to a gentleman that a very good indication that your program really works.
Thank you. Well, thank you for having us. You know, we really appreciate the opportunity to tell their story and to tell the agency's story.
Yeah.
I mean, Jamali, where are you going, buddy?
He went to get his bagel.
Went to Cat Find the Bagel.
Where'd you go, JJ? What are you doing? What are you doing?
He's going to the sky
he's
someday.
He's going somewhere. Hey, didn't you want to talk about your shoes and brands? And what did you say? Oh, 5 minutes. Look at this.
Yeah.
What's your favorite shoe? Favorite brand of shoe?
Jordans.
Of course.
Aim high, right?
Right.
Mm-hmm. How about you, Henry?
Jordans, Nikes, KDs.
Nice.
He has a long list.
LeBrons.
Whoa.
Excellent.
So a lot of the funding, some of the funding you guys get helps to facilitate their
things,
clothing, their foods, their needs.
Yeah. Absolutely. We get funding both from the local, our local Children's Services Council of Broward County, from the state through the Department of Children and Families and our community-based care lead agency, ChildNet, and then some federal funding from the Children's Bureau in Washington, D.C. But we also have to raise about $2.8 million, you know, to add quality and to really
annually?
Augment our services annually. $2.8 million, yep.
Wow. That's a big nut.
Yeah, and those are done, you know, a lot through special events, through the events that Nate was talking about, our Family Fitness Challenge in December, and our Hero Walk in January, but also through grants and private donations.
Good stuff.
So if you guys could say anything to our listeners that you want them to know about you or kids in distress, what would you say?
If you really, really want to be a foster parent, as Mr. Nate said, we really need more foster parents. So if you really want to be a foster parent, come to Kids in Distress.
How about you, JJ?
I don't know. I would like to say about how much I like being there. It's really fun. We get to go outside and play, like I said, and go places with other people. I'm really, really hoping this Christmas I get what I wanted.
And what do you want for Christmas?
A drone.
A drone.
A drone.
I want one too.
I wanted one for eight years. A tablet.
A tablet. A Minecraft Lego set.
Uh-huh. Set the bar high, buddy.
That's and right. An ear hog.
An ear hog.
How about you, Henry?
What do I want for Christmas?
What would you want for Christmas?
Where do I begin? No? Ideas? You can't want that much.
I love the look. If you're watching, you could see the thought process going into it.
Very pensive.
That's hard. I don't know what I
That's
want.
That's right. You got to think about it.
What's the first thing? First thing, top of your head. First thing.
What's this? If you could have it right now, what would it be?
An Jordan.
All right.
Jordan 12s.
Well, JJ and Henry, you two are surely a testimony to the amazing program, Mr. Mark, you guys have put together in Kids
Absolutely.
In Distress. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us, guys.
Thank you for coming down.
You're welcome.
Thank you for coming.
Thank
if we
you.
Can do anything for you in the future, Nate knows we can put ads on, PSAs on. We can promote anything we can do for you. And share with you guys. Phone number that we can reach you at?
Our phone number at the agency is 954-390-7654. Our reception is 1221. So we, you know, you can call us, get a hold of me. My name is Mark Doggie. I'm the CEO at KID. But most importantly, you know, certainly we have our big event on December 3rd is our Family Fitness Challenge. And we'd love to see everybody come out to our event on that day and support our kids.
And we're definitely going to be contacting you guys for our Kids Duck Fest Derby, which is March 25th, 2017. And you'll have fun to see that.
It's the Duck Fest. That's where I'll celebrate my birthday. 50 ducks in my name for all the kids.
Don't say that because I'll make sure everybody brings a duck. You'll get 50 ducks.
I think we can donate 50 ducks for my birthday. How's that sound?
Sounds good.
That's what we'll do.
We'll bring I like
50
it.
Ducks.
I got another question.
Okay, we gotta make it quick.
Henry, earlier you said you wanted to play basketball for the Cavaliers, right? Why do you like the Cavaliers that much?
He has to put Henry on the spot. Boy, what a nice guy. There you go. Yeah.
All right, guys, thank you so
Don't
much. Thank
that,
you,
Henry.
Boys.
You
thank you,
time.
Nate. Yes. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Kids thank in Distress. You will learn more about their programs going forward. Happy Friday, everyone.
Enjoy
Have a wonderful weekend. Be safe. What's Happy Veterans you? Day, and we'll see you on Monday.
Don't be late.
Bye-bye.
That's it for today's lunch break with Two Boys from Brooklyn. You're invited to join the break every day, Monday through Friday at 12 noon. So, if you missed some of the good stuff they served up today, there's more coming next time. Bring your lunch and the boys from Brooklyn will bring the smiles. And it's all live. See you next time. Now, go and enjoy the rest of your day.
Destination. OffleaseOnly.com.
Still dealing with all kinds of problems inherited from this morning. 95 northbound at Yamato, police activity. Shutting down that exit due to that problem we had with the train and a car. While they clean up that mess, Glades is still the best alternate. Also, 95 northbound after Congress has a crash blocking the left lane. Southbound 95 at Yamato does have police activity right as you exit. That's your traffic. I'm Danny Rivera.
This report is brought to you by the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer. The Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer is doctor-recommended and backed by more medical studies than any other thermometer. Get yours at Toys R Us and Babies R Us and other fine retailers today.
Exergen is changing the way the world takes temperature.
From the Exergen Temporal Scanner Thermometer Weather Center.
Happy Veterans Day and Happy Friday. I'm meteorologist Felicia Combs. We have a gorgeous day ahead. Tons of sunshine will continue, so take the sunglasses along. Highs will make it into the lower 80s with light winds, and that will make for a beautiful afternoon.
This report is brought to you by Compassion International.
Never thought of yourself as a hero?
That's what you'll be for a child in poverty when you become a sponsor with Compassion International. To find out how you can release a child from poverty right now, go to compassion.com.
Hiring people is probably the worst part of my job. It's such a hassle, the searching, the sorting through resumes. Most people don't have the right experience.
We started using ZipRecruiter about 3 months ago. Right from the start, you could tell it was going to make hiring a lot easier. One click and my job was posted to 100 plus job boards, all the top sites.
All of the candidates came to my dashboard, and it's easy to compare them. Thumbs up if I like them, thumbs down if I didn't. No emails and attachments, printing up docs, phone calls, none of that.
And I couldn't believe the number of great applicants we got. I had the person we needed within 1 week. I don't know how we hired before ZipRecruiter.
Whether you're looking to fill one position or 20, find the best candidates with ZipRecruiter, where your job is just one click away from 100 plus job sites. ZipRecruiter, the fastest way to hire. And right now you can try ZipRecruiter free. Just go to ZipRecruiter.com/connect. That's ZipRecruiter.com/connect. ZipRecruiter.com/connect.
If you owe back taxes, there's a lot you need to know, starting with rule number one. Don't mess with the IRS. They are cracking down this year by sending out heart-stopping letters, actively garnishing paychecks, levying bank accounts, and putting liens on homes and businesses. That's all true. But it's also true there's a way out. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative, an important government program for tax debt assistance. It's one of the biggest breaks the IRS has ever offered, so now's the time. You could qualify for a tax settlement that saves you thousands, even tens of thousands. Nobody knows this program like the award-winning experts at Optima Tax Relief. They have an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau and will work to get you the best deal possible. Don't mess with the IRS. For tax help you need, for tax help you can trust, call Optima for a free consultation.
Call 800-798-2477. 800-798-2477.
Fox News Radio, I'm Lisa Brady.
We honor those who honored our country.
1230 WBCT.
President Obama at Arlington National Cemetery, his final Veterans Day ceremony as Commander-in-Chief, also including another appeal for unity.
Veterans Day often follows a hard-fought political campaign, an exercise in the free speech and self-government that you fought for. It often lays bare disagreements across our nation.
He says as we try to come together,